A set has n elements. Find the sum of the cardinal numbers of all the subsets of it. You are watching Brain Exploders, the world where your brain starts working. Before solving this problem for a general set of n elements, let us solve it for a set A having only 3 elements to get a clear idea of the problem. Suppose A is a set of first 3 natural numbers. Subsets of A which have only 1 element in them are 3 in number. There are exactly 3 subsets of A which have 2 elements and only 1 subset which has 3 elements. Empty set is also a subset of A, but its cardinality is 0. Therefore, it does not affect the sum of cardinal numbers of all the subsets. Here we have one subset having 0 element, 3 subsets having 1 element, 3 subsets having 2 elements, and 1 subset having 3 elements. On adding all these, we get 12. We have to do the same thing for a set of n elements. If we make subsets by selecting only one element at once, then we can make n subsets. If we make subsets by selecting exactly 2 elements at once, then the number of subsets are equal to the number of ways of selecting 2 elements from n. Similarly, we can make other subsets. Hence, number of subsets having 1, 2 and 3 elements are nc1, nc2 and nc3 respectively. This is true for other subsets also. Therefore, sum of cardinal numbers of all the subsets is equal to nc1 times 1 plus nc2 times 2 plus nc3 times 3 and so on. Let this sum is equal to s. We can replace nc1, nc2 and nc3 by nc(n-1), nc(n-2) and nc(n-3) respectively by using the property nc(n-r) equals to ncr. Write these terms in reverse order. Place this equation under the previous one such that nc1 is below nc1, nc2 is below nc2 to get rid of any confusion in addition. Now add these equations. We get 2s equals to n times nc1 plus nc2 plus nc3 up to ncn. Sum of this series can be calculated by the binomial expansion of nth power of 1 plus 1. On putting this value in the obtained expression, we get s equals to n times n minus 1th power of 2. This was our solution. Let's move toward another question. There are 8 switches, exactly one of which is working and other are not. We have to find out which one of them is working. For this, we have 3 bulbs and 1 power supply. Wires connected to both the terminals of bulbs are outside a room, but bulbs are inside the room, so that we have to enter the room to check which of the bulbs are glowing. With the help of a proper connection of power supply switches and bulbs, we can minimize our number of entries in room. How many minimum number of times we will have to enter the room? In this figure, there are 8 switches in which only one is in good condition. You can make connections as you want. After that, you have to go into the room to check which of the bulbs are glowing. You can repeat this as many times as you want, but you have to make a strategy to minimize these repetitions. Try this question and comment us the solution, and if you have any question like this, then please share with us. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Explorers. Thanks for watching.